Alright guys, trailer work. So I have these planks already installed. They might get a guide down here so that they stay in the rail. But I found something better out. This pipe here is a 10 gauge. And so if I cut it in half, I actually get exactly what I need there for the rail. So that these boards stay in the middle, and in the middle here per axle they are actually in the stake pockets, so they don't flex out, they're staying down in the stake pocket. But here in the front they're very loose, so as you can see can flop out, and I'm not happy with it. Bigger problem is actually here in the back, because the board wouldn't be secure anywhere down here, so I have to weld something here in place as a guide rail, and over there as well. As you can see, there's a footprint of my tote, so it's actually the tote would slide in if I have the board out, no problem, and even if I have this welded on, it will stay in place. Did a little bit of work to the trailer, did a little bit of more paint protective on the springs and the parts to the springs, as well as the axle is being painted, so less corrosion there. I have a couple of corrosion spots still left, but this is another project. It's a dolly for actually the trailer to maneuver around. I bought it in Orlando. Both tires are blown. I'm gonna fill those with the foam inside, so that they are permanently expanded and never run flat again. I have another one here which is, as you can see, flat as well. What I'm going to use is a foam. I'll do an extra video on this in a couple days. I'm going to use a different type of foam, slow expanding, not rapid, and take the inner tube out and the hole, pretty much rim out, or leave the rim in place and just fill it up so it's solidly filled. I'll show the video how the outcome is. This is pretty much for slow moving only. So, but I have the board for the back here already here, and so this one has a width of, let's do it first in inches for you guys. Really, 1.5 inches. So for you guys which are metric, it's 38 millimeters. So you should be able to see it, 38 millimeters in width. So the 2R which I have as a leftover from the rail project has an inner diameter of 1.75 inches, which is in millimeters, 44 millimeters. Hope you can see it. It's shy on the 45 millimeters, so it's 44 millimeters. So what I decided is to actually use this piece which I have left, which is fairly long still, and if I would just use it for the wood itself, you can see the cut mark would be here, but then I wouldn't have any securement on top, so I'm adding more to it so that I can later on have even a second piece of wood braced on top if I want to, or change it out to a higher board, because the boards which I have in right now, they are only, I think they are the 10 inch, so 9 inch, actually only 9 inch and something high. So I'm not sure if you call that really 10 inch, but they are nice, but they are not as high as I might use them later on. So I want to have enough slide rail on top as well. So if I cut them 14 inch pieces, so this is 14 inch or 35 and a little bit over 35 and a half centimeters in length, and then cut them in the middle in half lengthwise, that gives me two C channels which I can then weld to the rail, which is exactly what we're gonna do today. So just watch and enjoy. In half on this size, and two pieces, missing an eighth, and what a thickness, so that's pretty much how much got removed, which is almost the same thickness as the original square tube. Now it's a C-channel and it fits right there, so the boards fit in just nice. So now I can focus on welding this in place on the trailer and getting two pieces welded here quickly on, so nothing is falling down to the bottom. So I can cut this out of this piece, two pieces, get them welded on, and we're good at this. And I can get this welded in place. All right, it's done.
Now you just use
Alright guys, there you see the final product. It's painted and slid in place. Thanks again guys. Please rate and subscribe and have a good day.